Progress in democracy. I was going to show you this. This is something that I had at the CPAC speech, and I want to show you this, and I'm going to spend some time on it tomorrow. I just want to show you, Oscar, if you can just get down here. I love this. Vote communist, but the line before it, elect, what's it say here? Elect progressive candidates for every office. Vote communist. All right. In the 1930s, there was a real power play, and the progressives held both Nazis and communists. Tomorrow, don't miss it, please. Okay, now, on Friday, the White House announced 4 more members to the National Commission on Fiscal Responsibility and Reform. Surprise, surprise, SEIU President Andy Stern was named. Why should you be surprised?
This is our moment, SEIU. This is our time. And if you keep marching with me and organizing with me in all the 50 states, together, you and I, we are going to change this country and we are going to change the world.
He means that. Stern said this is the chance to spur job growth, to talk about government-funded programs, and quote, while we're at the same time restoring long-term fiscal discipline and defining a clear progressive vision for our nation's future. You got it? A progressive vision. After all, Andy Stern only wants what's best for his country's workers. Workers of the world unite. What's wrong with that?
There are opportunities in America to share better in the wealth, to rebalance the power, and unions and government are part of the solution.
America.
But we need big answers, not small ones. Workers of the world unite. It's not just a slogan anymore. It's a way we're going to have to do our work.
What am I missing, America? Please. How are people not getting this? How are your neighbors not getting this? Andy Stern has shared the wealth, and now the unions and their pensions are in jeopardy. Because sharing the wealth, whether it has been at the barrel of a gun like Maoist or at the end of a baseball bat like unions, it doesn't work. I told you that back in April, the SEIU National Industry Pension Fund announced it had been put in what the feds called critical status or the red zone. We're talking about the pension funds that cover some 100,000 rank and file members. Take a look at the funded ratios of 13 SEIU local pension funds from 1996, this is the year that Andy Stern became union president, through 2006. It just goes straight down. You notice that? They're all in critical now. The middle line, show the middle line here. The middle line shows the average trend. You see that unions' benefits are funded at 90% in 1996 when Andy Stern took over, and they dropped now to 60% funded by 2006. It's worse now. By the way, when you reach 65% on a chart like this, the government says you're critical. It means you're ready to fail. And that is one thing the government understands really well, failure. I don't know about you, but I don't want Andy Stern on a panel to talk to us about our deficit and how to fix it. I mean, if he wants to testify in front of the panel to, you know, give an example of what not to do to our country, yeah, he's a good expert on that one. But fix it? No, I don't think so. Physician, heal thyself. But I wonder if anyone is actually looking to heal us. You've heard the goals of Van Jones. You've heard the goals of the communists, the progressives, and Andy Stern. You see, we've seen the statistics. We've seen his qualifications. Why would you pick this guy to help us out of our deficit? Let me show you again what his plans are. Restoring long-term fiscal discipline and defining a clear progressive vision for our nation's future. But you have to understand what that means. Do you not understand it? Has anybody explained this progressive vision to you? Is it the vision you want for America's future? Back in a minute.
Forget Greece. Turns out California's in worse shape. Next.
I warned you about Greece and their massive debt threatening the stability of the European Union and possibly the world. I talked to you last week about dominoes. But now, over the weekend, the head of JP Morgan says, don't worry about Greece or Europe. Look to California. Their debt alone could bring the country down. David Buckner is the president of Bottom Line Training and Consulting. He's also adjunct professor at Columbia University Teachers College. And he's also going on the road with me for a day of, I guess we'll call it Beck University.
It is.
Our American Revival Tour, which is just in, what, 3 weeks. First one is in Orlando, Florida. Check it out at glenbeck.com. Okay, so David, California, worse than Greece? Do you believe that?
Well, California is worse. Jamie Dimon was the one who articulated that, and it's worse because of the United States. It is our Greece. The problem is while Greece can separate itself from the EC, California can't.
Let me ask you this. How crazy would this be to say to California, you have capped oil and gas wells right now? They're capped.
Right.
All you have to do is just go take the nipple and just put a pipe on it, and you're done.
There's revenue potential.
Right. Until you cut your spending and until you start generating revenue that you can generate, right, we're not going to help you.
See, legally, they established with Proposition 13 that they couldn't tax further. That was the revolt that said enough of this ridiculous tax stuff. But they never tapped revenues or never fully vetted the revenues. When the economy goes up, they're fat and happy, and they're saying this is great. But they start spending like they're fat and happy.
Yeah.
The economy comes down, they're still spending like they're fat and happy.
How long before we really gather... We really see. I was out in California about 3 weeks ago. I think it's a different place. I really do. I saw closed businesses. I saw potholes on the highways and the freeways that I've never seen before. I mean, how long before California becomes apparent to the rest of the country?
Depends upon whether the government comes in, U.S. government comes in and does a bailout, or whether they shift to a cut. The issue is you're seeing businesses leave,
yeah,
you're seeing people leave. They're still trying to figure out, do we tax the rich more? Well, the rich are leaving.
Yeah.
The rich aren't rich.
Yeah.
I mean, everything is starting to fall out.
Now, there was another, who else was it that said this weekend that Japan,
right,
is also on the edge, worse than Greece?
It is worse than Greece. There's a little difference between Japan. Japan, if you take Greece, the United States with its California, and Japan, Japan's in between Greece and the U.S. on this.
Okay.
The only difference is Japan has huge amounts of debt. That debt is burdening Japan, but much of the debt for Japan is internal.
Okay.
They are savers there.
They also hold of our bonds.
They're
the number one now, not
they
China.
Do. So if they're in bad shape,
we're in trouble.
We're in trouble.
And didn't they, quote unquote, invest in the future? Didn't they do all kinds of spending programs? They've been like this for a long time now.
Well, they did two things. One, they did a lot of spending, a California approach, mm-hmm, okay?
And, well, America approach.
Absolutely.
And let's invest in the future with our roads and everything else, right?
The other thing they did is they raised taxes. They did a sales tax in 1997 that almost cannibalized the whole economy. So they were spending, they were taxing, and they weren't getting any benefit from it.
Oh, so it's completely different than what we're doing.
Oh, no, we're spending and we're taxing.
That's fantastic.
We're following right down the road of 1997 in Tokyo.
And how long do we have before it's apparent on which direction Japan is going to go?
Well, it depends upon the fact that Japan is still have the confidence of the world. But if you look at Moody's and others that are rating Japan, they're starting to say, the credit value of Japan is going to go down. If it does, it starts to drop.
Fannie and Freddie asked and got another, well, almost $16 billion.
This is not a government institution.
Yeah, no, not at all. But they can just go to the window and nobody seems to even care anymore.
Turn on the printing press.
Right. AIG now needs maybe another $20 billion. But you say, and we've got about 10 seconds here, you say the government is forcing
I think AIG is shackled. AIG is having to sell everything at a yard sale to get the government out the door.
And they're selling, and the government's making them sell all the things that are
and
profitable.
And the stuff that is profitable, Alico, AIA, and others, the government's saying sell, sell, sell. And they're saying, but it's a yard sale. Why would I want to sell at the yard sale?
All right, David, we'll see you again. Back in just a second.